bit faster than the old one, Gary. I want to go on it.
Hey, Gary, you're going to have to give me a go on this at the weekend.
Maybe.
I'll see ya.
Hey, Darren. Wait for Tom. He's supposed to be looking after him.
Make sure you come home with Darren.
Bye, Mum. Bye.
Come on in if you're coming.
Be careful.
I like this, it's quite nice. Get one of these when I'm old. Oh, what a cool stuff. Come on, let's go, Tom. We lost him anyway. See, look at that bloke's face.
Yeah, look. Someone's had a go at this.
Look, over there, there's a football.
Oh, yeah. Keep an eye open, you two.
Whoa, hang on, mate. This place is electrified. Look, just take a look.
Oh, that's a frightened little kids. You're right if you don't touch anything. I've seen people working up there.
Yeah, well, I don't particularly want to mess around with this type of stuff. It's not worth it.
Come on, Darren, Andy's going.
You like him? No bottle.
There's one or two that are a bit, you know, but all general, they're okay. Do you do this all the time?
Yeah, two or three visits a week.
Come on, quickly as you can, please. Darren, close the door. Right, now if you've got everyone. Now then, for your last science lesson of the term, we've got... Yes! Yes! For your last... lesson of the term, we've got Mr. Jones here from the electricity board. Now he's going to talk to you, show you some videos, so it's another lesson where you do nothing. Whoa. Now what he has to say is important, so listen.
Morning, I'm Ken Jones, and as Mrs. Benson said, I work for the electricity board. You know, the people who supply all the electricity you lot waste at home. Now, I've been sent along today to tell you about some of the dangerous things people do when they're near electrical installations. In short, I'm here to tell you how to avoid killing yourself. Now then, you look a pretty intelligent bunch. Well, some of you anyway. So you can read this sign then. And these ones? Of course you can. They all warn you about danger. Anyone know what one of these is? Or one of these? Anyone?
Mr. Jones?
Yes?
They're electricity boxes.
They're electricity distribution substations. And there's thousands of them up and down the country. There could be one at the end of your road. Now, if you see a sign like this stuck on the gate of a substation, it's pretty clear what it means, isn't it? What do you think it means?
It means you shouldn't go inside because it's dangerous.
Does everyone agree?
Well, if you don't touch the stuff inside, I've seen the workmen climbing all over the one near us.
But as you might have heard on the news, a young lad broke into a substation yesterday. And just like you, he could read the signs. But I guess he thought, they're for someone else. I'll be okay. And now he's dead. Unfortunately, it's not always the stupid people who get hurt. If you're not using your common sense, an accident can happen to any one of us, and it can happen in an instant. I'll show you.
We'd gone fishing to try out a new carbon fibre pole we'd got. He said we'd have more luck further down. It wasn't far, so we never bothered taking the pole to bits. Of course we knew about the electric cables. We'd fished there loads of times before. He just didn't think. He forgot the pole was sewn on.
Go!
That lad was burnt, knocked unconscious, and thrown into the river. All because he hadn't bothered to dismantle the fishing pole. His face and hands are going to be disfigured for life. Can anybody else think of any ways we could touch overhead cables by accident?
See?
Come on.
I told you.
Lots of them.
We've actually got to touch it to get out.
Anybody?
Could you do it with a tent pole, you know, like when you go camping?
Yes. Now, if you pitch your tent underneath cables, you risk forgetting that they're there. One slip with the pole, it's easily done. And look, there are other ways. People who forget how tall their boat mast is. People who fly kites or toy planes on wires. Put up CB or TV aerials. So, do you all get the idea? Look up and look out. Never go near overhead cables with any long objects. And certainly don't make this kind of mistake.
I only ran into the house to answer the phone.
Rubbish.
I'd left them playing outside on the front lawn.
I'll get it.
Lady down the road.
I just forgot the builders had left their ladder behind.
Watch out for the wires. They're only for a telephone, silly.
I thought she knew those cables were dangerous.
Oh, my God!
That's a mistake a lot of people make, thinking the power cables are for the telephone. Now, that little girl was electrocuted by the supply to the house. But what about a big bloke like me? Do you think I could be seriously hurt by the power from an ordinary little socket like this?
You'd need a bit by lightning.
I mean, we've all got them at home. You at the back, what do you think?
Sorry?
Have you got the answer?
Yeah, I'd say it would take more than that, sir.
Well, you're wrong.
Crawler.
If you touch the electrical supply in this socket, there's quite enough power to kill me or you at least five times over. So, you've got to treat electricity with respect. Understand how powerful it is. Keep your distance, or you might pay the penalty. Like the guys in this next clip.
We played there plenty of times before. We found a place to get under the fence. They'd left the door open this time. Everything was busted, the junk. We thought it weren't used no more. We were only mucking around, smashing things. I hit this metal box and tons of sparks flew out.
Hit it again!
He'd run up behind me. I didn't see him. It jumped out and got him. He was my best mate.
Those lads ignored the warning signs. And now someone's got to tell his parents that their son's dead. Your safety is your own responsibility. Any fool can walk into an empty building and get killed. The smart people take care of themselves. Those lads were being stupid. But there's one more incident I'd like you to see. Now just watch this guy.
He was stupid. Trying to prove how tough he was. I had a go at them kids.
Why do you fly your kites around here, eh?
We thought it would be okay, but the wind changed.
Lucky they let go of it. They'd have been electrocuted.
We should have told the police.
Suppose he never knew about high voltage electricity.
You're crazy!
He ignored the danger signs.
Leave it there!
He was stupid. He wouldn't come down. He didn't know electricity would go through the kite. It just jumped through thin air. He never touched the wire. He never touched it.
Well, you don't have to touch. Electricity jumps gaps straight from the electrical equipment through thin air to anything near. You, if you're close, you wouldn't stand a chance. You can't afford to take a chance with electricity because you can be killed just by getting near it. The moment you step past the warning signs, you're walking straight into danger. Any questions?
Yeah, what do you do if something gets stuck in the electrical equipment?
Phone the police. They'll call us and we'll make absolutely sure that all the power's been turned off before we go and get it. Never try to retrieve it yourself. Yes?
You said they let go of the kite. Does electricity really travel along string?
Yes, especially if it's wet.
How far can electricity jump?
The higher the voltage of the electricity, the further it can jump. Electrics.
Oh no, they're all we need.
Gary!
This is some bike. What's the problem?
Ain't sparking properly.
I'm gonna give it a clean.
Yeah, it'd be useful. Hang on to this.
I reckon we should have a whip round tomorrow to get another ball.
Well,
maybe. Now you, come with me.
Get your hand clear. You might get a bit of a shock.
Yeah, some guy was telling us about it today in school. It's powerful stuff, isn't it?
Save it.
Oh, look at that. It's only a loose connection.
Keep lookout.
Where's Darren taking Tom off to?
Oh, I don't know.
No, he wouldn't.
Get a football!
No, Darren!
Darren?
How did he get in?
Darren!
This way!
Tom! Darren! Darren!
No, Tom!
Those people ignored the danger signs. And now someone's got to tell his parents that their son's dead. Any fool can get killed.
You're right, if you don't touch anything.
Now what he has to say is important.
You wouldn't stand a chance. You can't afford to take a chance with electricity because you can be killed just by getting near. You don't have to touch. Electricity jumps gaps. The moment you step past the warning signs, you're walking straight into trouble.
Two young brothers died today after they entered an electricity substation to retrieve a football. Each suffered severe electrical burns and both were pronounced dead on arrival at hospital. A spokesman for the electricity board concerned condemned vandals who, it was believed, had broken into the compound earlier. The police report that some local youths are now helping with their inquiries. When you're told to stop.